Well, thank you all for being here, and I hope that you're still awake, because as a last speaker I have the difficult task to keep you motivated and attracted to my story. And a word of thanks, of course, to the AAS for giving me the opportunity to share some of the knowledge and experience we have on cycling. This is the name of my presentation, and the agenda is more or less different, because in my presentation I will go in depth into the importance of active mobility and cycling, especially the role of cycling in the mobility system, the systematic approach which needed it for that, the implementing safety measures, cycle rep, and a short summary. And along my story you will see what you can encounter if you visit, for instance, the Netherlands, a country where we have more cycles than inhabitants. We have 22 million bicycles in the Netherlands. And if you ever visited Amsterdam, you have to be aware, because cycles are everywhere. Left, right, behind, in front of you. And even if they come from above. And why is cycling so important and increasingly important? If not particular here in Singapore, you see that cycling is, well, moderately used. But it is growing in popularity, especially in dense cities. Because one of the main reasons is that the available space becomes more and more scarce. The density, more people per square kilometers, and if you will see in the next decade, more people will come to cities. And you will need to adjust your mobility system to that. You have to try to find a new way to get people to the destination. If you see what happens in the bigger cities across the world, then you see that cycling and active mobility becomes more and more important. Combine the different modes of transportation, public transportation, cycling, walking, and also the personal mobility devices. Come to that later. And there's no more for room inefficient modalities anymore. The car was important and is still important outside the cities, but in the city centers it becomes more and more difficult to drive, and you all have experienced somewhere a gridlock. Another important thing is that the livability, the quality of life for citizens, is very important. And not in the last place, health and safety. Climate is a big discussion, especially in countries like the Netherlands, but also in Singapore. Living below sea level, the rise of the ocean will threaten us all. Air quality is important for our personal health. There's social safety and, of course, health. Because if you be active in your mobility, it's good for your health. There's some opportunities and threats for bicycle traffic. It's beneficial for the user and for the government. As I said, the efficient use of space, the environmental friendliness of cycling, it's healthy and it's cheap. Be aware of the fact that it's even cheaper than public transport for the government. Cycling doesn't need so much infrastructure, and it's not only cheap for the user, but also for the government itself. But adjustment of the mobility policy is absolutely necessary, because not everyone can use a bicycle. Elderly people, people who are unstable, they have to have other opportunities. So your total mobility package should take that into account. The limited facilities which bicycle need are really necessary. So don't think that you can put bicycle in the midst of other traffic, because then it becomes very dangerous. And encouraging bicycle use without the measures which are needed is dangerous. It's really dangerous, and I will show you later. Well, the bicycle as a mobility system, it requires a combination of infrastructural, policy, educational, and promotional efforts. Promotion and awareness, and today we heard a couple of times that the user and its behavior is crucial because 90%, we've heard it today, of all accidents can be related to the personal decisions drivers make. I tend to have a bit of a different meaning because we're all people and we make mistakes. So we have to build a system which is fail-safe. You must not be punished when you lose control because you're distracted. Of course, not deliberately, but we all make these mistakes. So awareness and promotional campaigns is one part of it. And we have to educate people how to use bicycles in difficult circumstances. The integration, the combination with other modes of transportation, and mainly the combination with public transport, is a very powerful one. But you have to design it on a system level. And there has to be sufficient and safe bicycle parking. I don't know how it is in other countries, but to give you an idea, every year in the Netherlands, 900,000 bicycles are stolen. And it's increasing, because there's a lot of value in the new electric bicycles. So there are now gangs going around the country and stealing bicycles. So insurance is important, but also a good lock and prevention. And not last, certainly not least, is the safe system approach. And I will go into that more later. Well, this is the growing popularity of cycling, and I can't be at two screens at the same time, but what you see here is, let me see, yeah, different modes of transportation. This is the Netherlands, and you see people going for recreation, day-to-day use, child carriage. So it's one of the things which is in our culture. We need the bicycle for everyday use, not only for recreational purposes. And it's very powerful. The danger is that we get an increasing number of modalities. You see here you can expect in due time, the three-wheelers. This is a recent development, the cargo bike. It weighs up to 300 kilograms and has a width of a meter. This is an electric vehicle, the Biro. It's very popular in Amsterdam. It can contain two persons, but all those vehicles are dedicated to use the cycle path. And you can imagine what happens with so many bicycles and so many different modalities on the same infrastructure. Come to that later. What you see here is who's sharing the cycle path in the red circle. And all those modalities are, well, have to share the road. And to be honest, if you have I think the ring road is very dense here in rush hour. If you go into the cycle lanes in the Netherlands, it's even more dangerous and even more dense. So the question is, how are we going to cope with this? Because what you see here is a family of vehicles which don't belong together. The speed, the width, and the mass are not the same. So we have to reorganize our inner city infrastructure. And city planning and infrastructural planning is key to make it safe. Then I come to the risk of cycling, because every upside has a downside as well. In the Netherlands, I am sorry to say, but we have more fatalities among cyclists than among car occupants. And that's for the, I think, third or fourth year in a row. Especially people aged over 75, which still become more and more active. People become older. But if they have an accident, it's quite often fatal. And there's many single vehicle accidents and accidents with other users of the cycle path. But mainly the single vehicle accidents are important because that you can solve with a good cycling infrastructure. And I'll show you a couple of examples later. 33% of the cycling fatalities were riding an e-bike. So speed and the control of an e-bike is an issue. And there should be some kind of training for people who are stepping into the e-bike transportation when they have never done so. And you see here the combination between the older people and e-bikes. And the majority of cycling accidents occur during the day and not during night. So that's also an interesting thing. So on relative good circumstances, with high visibility, still cycling accidents happen. I promise you to go back to the SAFE system. And we have seen it a couple of times today. The SAFE system is built on three pillars. I would say safe behavior of the vehicle driver, rider, safe vehicles, and safe infrastructure. The whole system should be forgiven in a way that if you make a mistake, that you're not punished by being killed. And to be honest, the safe infrastructure is an important part of this. You can see a couple of things which are important. The public space design, uniformity and roundabouts, the mixed infrastructure, which needs speed reduction, cycle paths with different vehicle categories, the hard obstacles, the side markings, and the curbs. They are really very dangerous for cyclists. If you make a mistake, you fell over. And we have now the flattened curves in the Netherlands, which contributing to more safe cycling. So bear that in mind. And also what you see is that there's a lot of things going on the safe behavior side and the safe vehicle side. Before you implement cycling, there are three questions, the three W's to be answered. What's your goal if you want to implement cycling in your mobility system? Where do you stand? What's your state of development of your mobility system? Is there already a kind of cycle path, cycle lane, or is it just car orientated? And which actions are the most effective? Where should you start? What should you do? That you really have to ask yourself as a government when you, and if you want to advocate governments, what steps you should take to implement cycling in a successful and safe way. What I try to do is try to give an overview about the implementing of safe cycling measures. And we heard a couple of times measures which are, what I say, end of pipe. Wearing a helmet doesn't prevent an accident. You must be on up front. You must invest in precautionary actions. Safe vehicles, safe infrastructure, and good enforcement and regulations are very important to implement cycling in a safe way. And of course, when you have done all this and you're coming here, you can learn from your curative measures. You have to feed it back into your precautionary measures. This is a kind of a feedback loop which you should take into account. Let me say something very short about safe bicycles, because that's important too. Here in the middle, it's your truly, a couple of years ago when I started off with the ANWB, it's the late 70s, early 80s. And what we did is invent the side reflection on the bicycle tires. And what we heard today already was, make yourself visible. But that's only a small part of the message. It's not only making yourself visible, you have to make yourself recognizable as a cycle. And those big hoops show immediately that there's a cycle. And if it moves into a direction, then you can see also the speed which is going in the direction it's moving into. So it's very important to do so. We have invested in developing for the industry a kind of life cycle where a lot of technology is implemented. So lowering the seat post when you stop for elderly people that they can have both feet firmly on the ground so that they don't drop over. With, of course, a very secure stand with a good visibility and lighting. And last but not least, also the adequate theft prevention. We invested in that with a certification so that every single bicycle user can find and buy the good bicycle locks. Behavior and enforcement. A lot have been said already today, but it's of course very important not to be distracted. There's so many cyclists in our country looking at their phone while cycling, and it's a deadly habit, I can tell you. But luckily we have also the education. You see in the bottom a very big bus where we as a mobility club train youngsters to do so. And there's also enforcement. And it's very important too, because as I said, in a city like Amsterdam, it's anarchy. People don't have lights. They don't show where they are going. They go in the wrong direction. And you need a strong enforcement to educate people the hard way. Last but not least, the infrastructure. You see here an example of an ideal kind of cycle path. It's more than 3 meters wide. So even the bigger modalities which I showed you, like this cargo bike, can find their way there. At this moment, you can see it here. It's very crowded on the cycle paths. And if you mix it with those kind of vehicles, then we are now in a new phase. We have to reinvent the mobility system and the inner city planning. We have to make space for the environmentally friendly way of transportation, the active mobility. And it will cost some space for the car use. It's not in any other way possible. Let me say something about, because as a member of the board of trustees of IREP, I was on the on the birth of CycleRep. And CycleRep is a system where we try to have a good kind of design for a bicycle path. What you see here is what I said already earlier, crashes which do not involve others, conflicts with other bicycles and light vehicles, and conflicts with pedestrians are the main causes of bicycle incidents. So infrastructure is very, very important to organize it in the right way. And we have categorized it in low risk until extreme risk. And this this system analyzes the existing cycle infrastructure, but also we can advise you in the design. If you have not done it already, we can advise you how to design proper functioning infrastructure. Well, this is something which was already in a scientific article. Anna Niska from the VTI in Sweden, he has stated, and I completely agree with it, cyclists are now the biggest challenge we have in achieving Vision Zero. If we really want to bring down the number of fatalities and accidents on our roads, we have to invest in good cycling infrastructure and a good cycling approach. This is what we do. We have a network identification in CycleRep. We collect data, we process them, we calculate risk scores, and the risk scores will lead to generate safety treatments. And we can do it, as I said, before or afterwards. So it's a good thing to remember, and I'm very pleased to give you more detailed information about that now or whenever you need. Just give me a call. I'm more than happy to fill that in for you. This is an example of the network analysis we do. This is a bicycle route projected on a map, and these are the analysis where all the attributes which conflicts and which make cycling safe or unsafe are located and put down into the analysis. That will go down into safety treatment recommendations. That's what it is, and I think the graph is self-explaining. And due to time, I will skip this. And again, if you really want to have more information, please let me know. We started quite a short time ago, but we have already 10 countries and more than 1,000 kilometers analyzed by this method. And we're still growing. And a lot of cities, for instance, and mainly, they are very interested in how to handle the new cycling infrastructure. So there's a lot of information about it. CycleRep, don't forget it if you really want to make work of cycling. And I come to my short summary. What I have said, bicycles contribute to the quality of life in cities. It's important to connect all aspects of bicycle use at a system level. Many times there's a mistake being made by putting, for instance, a great bicycle park, but not asking yourself, are there any users? Is there any public transportation? Is there any school, university of in the neighborhood so that people are tended to use? And you have to connect it to the infrastructure, to their daily transportation, because bicycle users are not different from you and me, and we always ask ourselves the question, what's in it for me? Is it feasible? Do I have an advantage in using the bicycle? Road safety requires special attention, especially when modal shift is being pursued. If you really want to make work, then you have to make choices. And it's not popular, especially not for city councils, that you have to say, well, we have to give in a bit of space for car users. And the preventive road safety measures are preferable, as I said before. Don't start with implementing helmets. Of course, it can help you to lower the effect of a crash, but please start off with the precautionary measures. That's the way to go. Investing in safe and forgiving infrastructure is financially also effective, but it requires expertise and an eye for detail. As I showed you, the curbs on a cycle path are critical for safe use. CycleRep is a method which you can use, which can visualize the safety of cycling infrastructure. So know that, and IRED knowledge and experience can be used during design and also afterwards for the quality of safety of cycling infrastructure. I want to thank you for your attention. As I said, it's a lot of information. I can elaborate on this all day, but time is unfortunately a little bit short, but don't hesitate to give me a call or write me an email. I really want to help you further, because there's one thing which drives us all, and that saves some lives in traffic. Thank you very much.